Farmers are decrying the heavy taxes imposed on them amid the climate changes. They thus want government to reduce on the tariffs to enhance fish farming in the country thrives. Take a look.
While touring the cages, Bolingo John, Lake Operations Supervisor at Sun Fish Farm, found in Bukungu, explained that they are currently facing a challenge of hazards and disaster which have lasted since 2020. This is coupled with floating islands which demolish their fish nets on top of seasonal water weeds.
Breakaway papyrus, floating portions of land which come and sometimes surpass our boundaries and damage our cages, and theft also. You cannot rule it out, however much that one is somehow controllable.
Bolingo, with his two colleagues, currently rare fish on a large scale, and they have over 72 cages and 52 fish ponds for young fish. The dealers say they also face the challenge of limited feeds, which prompts them to import. They are also concerned of over-increasingly discharged chemical influence into the lake, which is likely to cause them losses.
With food, the feed quality, we used to have people who could do feed around locally, but the challenge was with quality, basically, like mentioned it. And we were noticing that our fish could not grow, so we decided to start importing feed from outside. We import feed from different sources as long as the quality is good.
Robert Osinde, the president of Uganda Cage Fish Farmers Association, agrees with his members. He asked government to prioritize cage fish farming as a way of sustaining fish in the lake, adding that fish in the lakes have reduced.
I would actually advise the ministry to still come up with a more sustainable approach to reinforcement, but not closing the lake. Because I believe all these fishermen, they fish on the surface of the water, so they can be seen. Can we get a radar that is seeing all what is happening in the lake, so that we have a one control point where the control cameras are seeing everybody in the lake, so we can easily notify the patrol team and say, go in this area, check what they are doing. Are they doing the right thing or not?
The association has also asked government not to close the lake as millions earn their daily bread from fishing. Fish farmers contribute over 60 billion shillings to the GDP every year. Story by Emmanuel Balukusa for the news.